Hello, Fairfax County Public Schools. It's another day in our schools, and we're at wonderful Weyanoke Elementary with Principal Felicia Usher and School Board Member Sandy Evans. Today, we're going to really focus on looking at teacher-driven professional development.
Yes, we are. We've really worked hard at Weyanoke to make sure that our teachers have input into what types of things we learn about so that they can drive their own development for their instruction with students. And so we do a number of things through Google surveys, through conversations, courses that we take to really drive where we're going to go as a building, as well as individual coaching sessions with individual teachers.
What are teachers really saying they want in terms of high quality professional development here at Weyanoke?
They definitely like being able to choose what they want to learn about. They really want to know more about small group instruction.
Small group instruction. Well, that's our workshop model that we've been doing with reading workshop and math workshop. We've been showing some snippets of that over the year.
Definitely. And really looking at what are some high yield strategies that we can use with our students during the focus lesson, during tier one instruction, to reach as many students as possible.
Well, we talked about one of those five growth drivers as being high quality tier one instruction. What have you all been focused on for your professional development needs, and how has it impacted students in your classrooms?
In our class, last year I co-taught with a coach, and we adopted the LC model for language arts. And with that, the impact on the students is it built authentic readers and writers.
What's LC? What's the LC
literacy
model?
Literacy collaborative. So basically, it's reading and writing. Mm-hmm. So they're actually reading, and they read for 40 minutes by the end of third grade, and they're writing actual books. As you saw before, we actually celebrated our authors' party, and they see themselves as real authors. I was lucky enough to co-teach with a coach all of last year.
Wow.
And now this year we have an LC class that we meet once a month, and we get to choose what the topic of the class is.
Fantastic. Well, what about you? What sort of professional development have you asked for, and how's it helped you in your classroom?
Yeah, so one thing that I'm really focused on this year is teacher language, and we actually had our instructional coach come in for a few cycles, and we focused on our math block, and I said I really want to reach the students in an authentic way and question them so that they're creating their own meaning and I'm not just giving them the answers.
What do you mean by teacher language? Tell me a little bit more about what does that mean?
So language has a huge effect on how our students react to us and what they learn from our language. So if I'm asking them questions that elicit higher level responses, I'm not just giving them the answer.
Which one's two-thirds, the blue or the green? Excellent. Our educators know what's best. They want to focus on student success, which is our foundation in our strategic plan. And professional development, teacher-directed professional development, is a big way of getting there. So
much energy here. There's so much positivity. The instruction is just top-notch. The professional development, of course, is always important. So thank you so much for showing us around today.